Days when I came to maturity, the powers of ordination began to speak, and God began to change my appetites. Those were the things that carried me, and my steps were guided. And the first time I entered Reverend Chris's meeting, he was talking about the fires of eternity. He said, I saw a white throne. Revelation 20 verse 10. He said, every soul appeared before the white throne. And he said, books were opened. And he said, another book was opened, which is the book of life. He said, if a man's name is not found, he is cast into the lake of fire. What is this? He read Ezekiel chapter 3 verse 18. He said, if I tell a wicked man, he will die, and you don't tell him, I will demand his blood of your hand. It was as if he was talking to me. I said, what is this? What is this? What is this? Not many days in the place of prayer, God carried me visibly like this. My physical body was carried into the past, and I saw the man of God, and he said, this is how to live your life. Why? Because the powers of ordination began to call. This is how to live. And he brought me back, and he carried me again another time, and I met him, and he gave me his iPad. He said, go and preach the gospel. What? In the flesh, I ran and joined Christ's embassy. I said, this is my father. I didn't know that the protocol of ordination was playing out. When the time came and I understood what he taught, he said, your training is over. Another hunger came again. I separated myself, fasting and praying for 21 days, and a voice came to me. He said, call there now. I caught him, and he told me about Apostle Aroman. He said, have you heard him? I said, who is Apostle Aroman? I'm listening to Pastor Chris Akilome and telling me about Apostle Aroman. Who is he? He said, he's in Makodi. I said, nothing is happening in Makodi. He said, go by the library. I stood up on Friday. I said, it's late. Maybe on Saturday. On Saturday, I stood up. It was 6. I said, it's late. And on Sunday, I got up. It was 5:30. I said, I will go there. I couldn't rest. And when I entered, it was in March 2014. And Apostle was only giving a child the way of the Father. And when I stood at the door, he said, this is your father. This is your home. What are you calling? It's called the power of ordination. It was Apostle that told me. He said, you are not a pastor. He said, if they make you a pastor, they will choke what God has put in you. He said, you are a striker. God has called you to go to the nations of the world. And he will have a meeting. He will say, Mike, go and represent me. How will I represent Apostle Aroman Osai? He was teaching me how to stare the fire of my ordination. They will invite him a JCCL convention. He said, go and represent me. Sir, when I heard Apostle Aroman Osai, it was as if a God was talking. I couldn't write anything. I marveled, who is this man? Where does he come from? And then that man, in less than 2 years, telling me to represent him. Because God sent you to men that will build you in the days when the powers of your ordination begin to speak. Most of the meetings you go for, you don't go for them because of the publicity. Your steps were being ordered. Saul got up. He was looking for his father's meeting as he didn't know that the protocol of ordination had been set in motion. He went past 4 nations, and when he came to Samuel, Samuel said, is it not because the Lord has anointed you king over his people? The guy thought he was looking for access, but ordinations were manipulating him. Every time hunger comes, ordinations are manipulating you. Every time there is restlessness until you attend the meeting, ordinations are manipulating you. Until you come to that point where you can hear the voice of God. For Moses, it took him 40 years wandering in the wilderness until the Bible said in Exodus 3:1, he said he came to the backside of the desert. There are no green pastures in the backside of the desert. What carried him there? It was the power of ordination. And when he reached there, he said he came to Horeb, the mountain of God. And that was the day the scribe that wrote about the life of Moses began to write in heaven. The whole story of Moses before 40 did not exceed 1 chapter. Because that was not part of what God spoke in heaven. His life began to speak when the embers of ordination was lit on earth, and he saw a burning bush that was burning and was not consumed. And suddenly God told the same man that ran away from Pharaoh, he said, go down to Egypt. I have heard the cry and the affliction of my people. If you heard them, why did you come to me? Ordinations. They are the precursors of true alignment. They